This was like the start of his greatness, that moment in Cleveland in 1989. I'm Rob Parker, and this is my story on greatness. People look at Jordan, and most people think he is the GOAT. You know, he won all six championships, all six MVPs. But I feel a little closer to the story because I was there. It's 1989. I'm an NBA beat writer. I cover the Nets, but it's playoff time, and I'm covering the NBA playoffs, the Cavs and the Bulls, in Cleveland. And I'm 25 years old. I'm sitting courtside right at center court. And remember, the Cavaliers were good then. So people thought the Cavaliers were going to win that series at Game 5. They had home court advantage, and it's a crucial moment. You know, there's only 3 seconds left in the game, and it was all going to hinge on Michael Jordan getting the basketball. It's like, he's going to get the ball, and it's either they win the series in advance, or it's all over. So I thought to myself, would they allow Michael Jordan to even get the basketball or have a chance? There's no time to pass to anybody else. So he had to make a move and make a shot. And he makes this incredible shot over Craig Elo. And Elo played great defense on it, but Jordan made the shot. And it was incredible for us as the writers who got to witness this, because this was all new. NBA Commissioner David Stern wanted to bring the writers. We used to sit up top out of the way. And he wanted to bring us down so we could hear all the action and be able to describe the scene better from having an understanding and a view of it closer than most people. So we were able to see this up close and in person. And I'll tell you, it was one of the most unbelievable things I'd ever seen. That building went silent in Cleveland when Michael Jordan knocked that shot. And I can just remember him jumping up in the air, thrilled, pumping that fist, because he had just won a game 5. And back then, it wasn't a 7-game series in the first round. It was the best of 5. And the Cavaliers had game 5 at home. They were supposed to win and move on, but Michael Jordan showed his greatness that night, and that was the start of something. But I remember talking to the writers during Jordan's reign in moments like that, and we all thought we were watching something special right then and there. It wasn't after the fact or after he had started to win some championships. We knew he was a different breed and that he was something special. And there were times we would look at each other, you know, tap each other and go, can you believe we're sitting courtside watching this guy play every night during the playoffs? They didn't win the championship that year and seal the deal, but that was the glimpse into seeing what this guy could do and where he could take the league. And you know what? He went from that part as a starting point onto the greatness of being arguably the greatest basketball player we've ever seen.